Hello my dear students, welcome back to my channel. Today in this session we are going to learn about one more geometrical shape, and it is circle. Okay, we are going to learn more about circle and its parts. What are the parts of the circle we are going to learn? So the things which we are going to learn in this session is center, radius, diameter and chord. Okay, so first of all I wanted to tell you a secret, that a circle is a closed figure. A circle is a closed figure. As you can see here, I had drew you a circle and it is a closed figure. It is not having any end. Okay, it is not having any open part, and circle has no sides and edges. And a circle is such a thing that attracts the attention of the whole world towards it. And for example, if you can give me the examples of circle, it will be good. You can think. Okay, the shape of a circle is like this. Okay, it's a bangle. One more example I can give, it's a lid of a bottle, and you can see it's a bowl. Okay, bowl, a steel bowl, a steel plate. Okay, and some more examples of circle is bicycle wheel, a card wheel. These are the examples. And other examples, like in eatable we have pizza. Okay, pizza shape is also a circle and round shape. And when your mother cooks nice delicious soft chapatis, the shape of the chapati is also a circle, round shape. Okay, there are many more. Circle are a shape of a round. So now in this chapter we are going to learn about what is a circle. Can you see here on the board I drew one circle? So the things which are inside the circle are the interior part of the circle, and the things this surface which is outside is the exterior part of the circle. Interior part which are inside the circle are called the interior parts, and the surface which is outside, it is the exterior part of the circle. So for example, to understand better, I have made a circle with a paper. You can see, you can use a steel board, okay, to draw a circle, or a plate, whatever you like, you can use and make a circle. It's a free-handed, okay, free-handed also you can draw. So the circle, now if I, for example, if I draw one line on a circle, on a respective two points, like if I take A and B on a circle, wherever, okay. So the line which is on the circle, on a respective points, like A and B on the circle, it is called the chord of the circle. A line which you can draw on the circle, which doesn't passes through the center of the circle, is called the chord. So to know the exact center point of the circle, what you have to do, first you fold the circle equal parts, okay, it should be a equal parts, then you will get the center of the circle. Okay, again one more time you fold the circle paper, and then you can unfold it, you will get the center of the circle. So here this is the center. I had just marked this as the O. O is the center of the circle. Same thing I had written here also on the board. Just see, O is the center of the circle. Center is the center point of the circle, which divides the circle into different parts. It's a center. So center, you understand, center is a point. Point of the circle, from where you can draw the circle. Now chord. Chord means a line which you draw on the circle with two points wherever, okay, on the circle, here, but it should not pass through the center of the circle. It is called a chord. See here, see, example I am giving you, these are the chord. So chord is nothing but it's a line on the circle which joins two points. Okay, it's not such a big thing that you're not able to understand, but it's a different word which you're going to learn, that is chord. Chord means a line only. Okay, chord means nothing but a line on the circle which meets two points, respectively two points on the circle. It's a special line on the circle. Understood chord? Now we are going to learn about the radius. Okay, we are going to learn about what is the radius. Radius means, okay, radius is also a line, but this line joins the center of the circle to the other point on the circle. So radius is always a line which joins the center. You can make a line from the center of the circle to the point on the circle wherever. Okay, so here also if you wanted to put a point and join this point to the center point of the circle, you can name it as anything. Okay, like YO is the radius, here Z and O is the radius of the circle. So two radius, okay, the center of the point, from the center point to the point on the circle, two radius makes diameter. This radius plus this radius makes two points. Radius, two radius together makes a diameter. Understood the radius? Radius is the half of the diameter. Radius is always a half of the diameter. And what is diameter now? What is diameter? So diameter is always a line which joins and passes through the center of the circle to the point on the circle. Okay, so diameter is the longest chord. I told you chord means don't take so tension. Chord means it's a line. Chord is a line. Diameter is the longest chord on the circle. And radius is the half of the diameter. Understood? So diameter always passes through the center of the circle. And it is the longest chord on the circle. It is a double time to the radius. Radius is the half of the diameter. Two radius makes one diameter. Radius plus radius makes one diameter. Diameter is the longest chord on the circle. And chord is the line on the circle which you can draw anywhere when joining two points on the circle, respectively two points on the circle, but it should not pass through the center point on the circle. Chord is a line. Okay, and radius is the half of the diameter, but it joins the center point of the circle, and wherever on the other point you can draw wherever on the circle. Understood? So in this chapter we have learned center. Center is the center point of the circle. Then radius. Radius is the half of the diameter and it touches the center point of the circle and other point wherever on the circle. Then chord is a line on the circle which joins two points on the circle. Then diameter is the longest chord on the circle and it passes through the center of the circle. And chord means a line. Understood? So in this session I completed these four topics. So I'll see you in the next video. I request everyone to please like, share, subscribe, hit the bell icon. And one more request I wanted to make. If you have any suggestions or comments, please inbox me.